Here, for example 3, the first line is in slope-intercept form, so that means b is negative 3, which means our y-intercept is 0 comma negative 3. Then our slope is negative 2, which we plot our y-intercept on the graph and then use our slope of negative 2 to get the other points. Notice that I can use down 2 and to the right 1 and up 2 to the left 1 to get multiple points for this line. And then once all my points are created, I can connect them with a line. Moving on to line 2, it is in standard form, so that means I have to find the y and x intercepts. So I plug in 0 for x to find the y. Doing so allows me to divide by 3 to get y to be negative 3, which means our y-intercept is 0 comma negative 3. Plugging in 0 for y to find the x, I can divide both sides by 6. That allows me to get x equal to negative 3 halves, which means my x-intercept is negative 3 halves comma 0. From here, I can graph my two ordered pairs and connect them with a line. And as you can see, the two lines overlap one another, meaning that there are infinite solutions. Until next time.